Go to me.
Over here like this. Look. Like this. Ooh. Good. Stretch the back.
Hey, what's going on?
What's going on?
Yeah.
We're stretching. Opening up our hips. Mm-hmm. Like this, look. Get back. Sit back. Just like that. You could go like this. There. Sit like mommy. Right here. There you go. Now go forward like this. Good. And go straight. Go ahead. Head down. Hands out. Hands out. Good girl. Good girl. Stay right there. And breathe in. Breathe in. Breathe in, breathe out. Good job. Okay. Now, you want to come up? We can look straight if you want, like this. Hunter, you want to look straight? And down. Hunter, look over here. Pay attention. Up and down. Down. Bend forward. Bend forward. Touch your toes. Roll your head. Roll your head. Look. Keep your knees straight. Good. Good. It's okay. Let's practice. Okay, ready to come up? Breathe in. Okay. Now, mommy needs to open up hips. Yes, you ready? Come on. Come beside me, right here. Come beside me. Mommy needs this, first of all. Okay. Now, get on your knees. I want you to come right here.
Get on your knees.
Ready? On your knees. Okay. One foot forward, one knee down. Good girl. Now bend forward. Up. And bend all the way. Good job. Now put your hands up. Just like that. Straight. If you need balance, follow mommy. Hey. Follow mommy. Use your words, baby. You're doing a great job. Great job. Okay. Now switch. open up our hips, right? Come back here. Come back here. Sit down.
Ooh, look.
Good job.
Good job.
Good job, Mommy.
Thank you. Now.
Yeah.
Mommy needs the mat for this.
Mat for this.
Mm-hmm.
Mat. Mat, Mommy.
The mat. This is the mat.
Mat.
Mm-hmm. And you're gonna, ooh, be careful. You're gonna put one leg over here, like that, and lean forward. God.
You do it with ghosts.
Yeah.
Ghosts.
Ghosts? See a ghost? There's a ghost.
I'm going to hearts.
Hunter's crying. You're gonna cry. See a ghost? Yeah. Oh my God. I need cookies.
Mommy, are you laying on your
Grandma?
No, cops.
Cops? No. Cops? Use your words.
No, don't.
You know how to use your words.
No, ships.
Those are not words.
Ships.
What's that?
Ships. Great ships.
Ships.
Ships. Ships.
You making fun of me? Want to try what I'm doing?
No, juice. Mommy, juice, Mommy.
Hmm?
Juice. Mommy, look, juice.
Yeah!
I'm going to go so angry.
Now we're gonna get in this baby pose. Ready? Just like that. Grab your feet and pull toward you. Pull toward you.
No, Mom, it's my feet.
Oh, I'm sorry. Good.
Oh, my.
Good. Ow!
Sorry.
Don't forget to breathe.
Respect. Respect, mommy.
I just had an accident. It's okay. Toes up like this, facing the ceiling.
Mm-hmm.
Put them together.
Mommy's singing.
And touch. Go forward.
Mommy's singing. No. Stay, mommy. Mommy's song.
You gotta do what I'm doing. Bend, put your head to your toes. Like mommy. Look, head to toe. Head to toe.
You toe.
I'm switching now.
I'm stretching now.
Stretching out.
Stretching now.
Mm-hmm.
With my mouth.
You just have a lot to say right now, don't you? Okay, let's come over here. Let's talk about some stuff with our viewers.
Viewers.
Yeah, say hello.
Hello.
How are you today?
How are you today?
Okay. So what are we going to talk about here? Use your words, baby, so everybody can understand. Okay. So what we're going to talk about today is hip openers. And something that I am relearning. Hip openers.
Hip openers.
Where are your hips? Right here. Your hips. And what I'm relearning is, I'm sorry if I'm not looking in the camera, I'm just looking at myself talking. What I'm relearning, which basically I'm just coming across again and realizing that it's one of the most important things I need to study and pay attention to for my own personal and emotional, physical growth and success, is opening up my hips and the benefits of opening up your hips. Now our hip flexors are.
I'm scared, mommy. Scared.
You scared of what?
Scared alligator.
Our alligator. There's no alligator here. But
alligator.
Baby, pay attention.
Scared.
Listen and pay
mommy,
attention.
You're scared.
No, there's no reason to be scared, my love. Why don't you sit up? Yeah, sit on your butt. Where's your construction paper? So, sorry. Some of the benefits of opening up your hips are unlocking deep personal, emotional baggage up here. And
how that works is our hip flexors are super tight. They're super tight all the time, and they never get to release any kind of energy or tension and relax. Most people are really tight in their hips, and that's me. And you know, thinking about it last night and stretching last night, it's probably the reason why I had such bad, terrible back pain during my labor in my 27 hours of trying to pop her out, because I just have extremely, extremely tight hips. What that limits is a lot.
That's a lot.
One, you don't have a wider range of motion. Like, let's say the arm is naturally doing often, which is all of this. Your legs pretty much do this. Back and forth, back and forth. Yeah, here and there. But it's not extending out in all directions, drawing oxygen and blood to that muscle in that area. So it lacks a lot of release. So once we start to do that, and once we start to do very specific stretches every single day to really release that tension, you won't really understand the benefits of it. Now, I'm going to tell you something in reverse, a learning curve I came across that was... Hunter, you're very distracting.
Mommy, it's distracting.
Ow, okay, I hit your butt, not my back.
And mommy got a bad chesty.
What are we talking about here? We're talking about stretching, right?
Stretching, yeah.
Tell them you have
come
to
here,
release.
Mommy, come here.
Okay. Tell them you have to release.
Release.
Release. No one can see your face.
Look at face.
I got it. I got
it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, good. Good. Let go. Look, come over here. Okay. So, every day, you want to do very specific stretches that are hip opening stretches. There are a lot of yoga poses that will do that for you. A lot of just things that you can do anywhere, even sitting on a chair. There was a book I once picked up. It was given to me after the author died. She was the writer of this book, and it was called Chair Yoga. And funny thing is, I got a lot of her clothes too, and they were just gorgeous clothes. No, we can't talk right now. Oh. So, there are so many things to do. Let's just say that you have a job that requires you to sit down all the time. How are you going to, you know, really exercise that area of your, you know, your hips and your body? Chair yoga. It's totally possible. There really isn't an excuse. There is no excuse that will prevent you from doing 1 minute or even 15 seconds of releasing some tension in your hips. And you just kind of have to do your research. So what I've learned, ew, Hunter, don't do that. That is so, where did you learn that? Just tell mommy. Move back. So there's a lot of tension and emotions built up. Now let me give you a reverse story of me in my process of learning. I'm talking. Listen. So when I started doing yoga regularly, and I'm not saying now that I still do it regularly, there are times in my life where I do it regularly and then other times where I'll stop. Hunter?
Mommy?
Just listen with your ears.
Squish your ears.
And close your mouth. Okay. When I started learning, I've come to the knowledge. Arr, arr, arr. Okay. I've come to realize that what yoga is for me and what it is for a lot of other people as well, which is, it's a challenging thing that you put yourself through that taps into your fears. And it shows you pain and it shows you what you're made of. And emotionally, listen. It releases, you start to, once I started learning that hip openers was something that I really wanted to get into for a lot of reasons. Let me give you some of those reasons. I wanted to be more flexible. I wanted the wider range of motion. I wanted to prevent injury while working out. I wanted to be healthier. And also I wanted a stronger sexual sensation. And you get that by drawing blood to your pelvic area, and that's just moving that area and making sure that oxygen is getting there. And when it's not that area, I mean, could you imagine if oxygen didn't get to, in your blood, if you didn't have oxygen going to like a portion of your body, like let's say your feet would die. And that's just the way the body works. And so if you don't start working on those things, they'll eventually not, and the body is an amazing thing, but it recovers itself if you just give it time and give it the space and the room and the support to, it can heal itself. It's a fantastic thing. But after a while, you know, you kind of just lose sensation of things. And, you know, that's why exercise on a daily basis is so important to maintain your health. Maintain oxygen throughout your whole body. And just so it can respond for you. So I did it for all of those reasons. And quickly realized, doing it after a certain amount of time, that it was tapping into some emotions that I've never tapped into. I would start to practice and reach really hard poses that stress out that area. It started to give me a headache, and I started to feel a way that I didn't even feel was possible. I didn't start off feeling like I didn't want to do yoga, and then in the middle of it, I started feeling like I wanted to stop because I was starting to hit those areas and those points where I would feel those emotions. And I was at a friend's house talking about this portion. This portion of your body.
Here. I need body.
Mm-hmm. And why I don't work it out as often. Now, if you look at my hamstrings, they're pretty dominant. I mean, you gotta see it. I have a lot of muscle back here. It's like crazy. I've done a lot of walking. And challenging myself in that area for a very long time. So the reason why I don't work this area is because it has an emotional, I have an emotional attachment to it. So, and I register that very easily. I have never worked out that area to the point of failure ever. And it's because I fear that area of my body and working it out. So lunges and squats and just a whole bunch of other exercises that I've learned that I don't know the names of right now, to work that area. Oh my goodness. It hurts and it makes me want to stop. And sometimes it even like made me want to, I started to feel emotional because I felt like I was being defeated. But ultimately, who is being defeated? Me. I'm defeating myself. I'm not challenging myself. I'm not pushing forward. and I haven't gotten very far. So these are some of the challenges. These are some of, this is some truth. In some of the challenges that I have to look forward to, continuing to open up my hips has to be a daily practice. And building muscle in these areas. I have muscle, but specific areas.
I got wings.
Here?
Mommy, wings.
Oh, thank you. My rings are in the chalk.
Wings.
So these are things that I just wanted to mention. So I may not have given you all the information and a bunch of facts about emotions connecting through the nervous system that reach your brain once you start opening your hips and the possibilities. The reason why I haven't mentioned these is because I just came across it and I believe it because I've lived it when I first started. I just didn't know what I was finding. I just started to come upon these feelings. So the point here is that I encourage you to go out and do your research. Oh, thank you, baby.
I welcome, Mommy.
I love you.
I love you. I welcome.
If there is an area in your physical vessel that you feel you need to start working on and bringing oxygen to, working out, really exercising that portion of your body, working the muscle, bringing it back to life, then you should start paying attention to that and actually start challenging yourself in that way and start to do it so that you can see the possibilities that spawn from it, the benefits that you get. One of the other things that I learned along my fitness journey, especially before I had her, which I was much more in shape. I was walking more than 8 miles a day. On my days off, I was working full time, so on my days off and even after work is you have to connect your brain with that muscle group. So let's say that you're wanting to gain muscle in your butt. You want bigger glutes. You want a bigger, nice, round, smooth butt. It's really important to concentrate on those specific muscle groups and not do something. Let me not say not. There's a big movement right now on social media, and that's squatting for a bigger butt. But a lot of people don't know that squatting is a head-to-toe exercise. You're working every single portion of your body at once by squatting. Now, to concentrate on specific muscle groups is getting ahead faster in reaching the goals that you want. I would love a nice round butt. So what I would have to do is work on those three muscle groups, those three glutes. And it's not as easy as just lifting your leg back constantly and doing that, making sure that you keep good posture. You have to make sure you keep good posture, like doing it correctly to where you start feeling the burn. Connecting your mind, thinking about that muscle as you're working it so that you know that you're doing it correctly. You also want to keep breathing consistently while thinking about that muscle, while keeping correct form, while keeping a tight core. Proper form prevents injury. Proper form creates results. And that's one other thing that I really had to learn, connecting the mind with the muscle. I was doing squats for days, never felt a thing in my glutes, never. Until I started to connect my mind with that muscle group. And I realized wasn't.
Mommy says?
You outside?
Outside.
Okay. I quickly realized that my form was off. I quickly realized that
I was holding my breath, and I also quickly realized that my knees were going past my toes, so I wasn't sitting back and squatting. Those are Evelina's shoes, so you should put them back in the box so you can send them to her. So, no, baby, go put them back in the box. Baby, those are your baby shoes. You don't fit in those anymore.
No, we don't move, Mommy.
We're going to ride your scooter outside, okay? We can go outside in a minute. So, I just wanted to drop that info. 31 minutes. I hope that this helped anybody, maybe even inspired someone to get up, move around. She can be, I can't, you know, do things the way I used to because I have her around, but it doesn't stop me from trying. There's no reason why you shouldn't even try. If you have some goals and you have some things that you need to work through, whether that's emotionally or physically, most times they connect and they have a lot to do with each other. So being mindful is something that is so, so, so important. And I encourage everybody to be as mindful as they possibly can. So I'm going to leave you with that. Hope everybody has a great day. Bye.